Normally, only with head movement does fluid within the inner ear also move, informing the brain that a head turn occurred. However, if a crystal called an otolith gets displaced into the semicircular canal of the inner ear, BPPV dizziness occurs. Fluid movement occurs due to the crystal rather than the head turns, causing the brain to think movement has occurred even though none has happened. The Foster half-somersault maneuver is performed to treat this posterior canal BPPV by trying to get the loose crystal out of the canal. The maneuver is started by kneeling. While kneeling, the head is quickly tipped upward and back. The somersault position is then assumed with the chin tucked as far as possible toward the knee. The head is then turned about 45 degrees toward the shoulder to face the elbow. This position is maintained for 30 to 60 seconds. While keeping the head turned at 45 degrees, the head is then raised to be aligned with the back and shoulder. This position is maintained for 30 to 60 seconds. While keeping the head turned at 45 degrees, the head is then raised to the fully upright position. At this point, the maneuver is completed and the patient can sit back up. So what's going on with these position changes? Essentially, the head is moved in such a way to manipulate the crystal to fall towards the canal opening. With each position change, it takes about 30 to 60 seconds for the crystal to settle into the most dependent position in the canal. If turns are made before the crystal has a chance to settle, the crystal may fall back the wrong way and the maneuver will fail. It is also important that the head positions are angled correctly or else the crystal will not settle to the correct position in the canal and the maneuver will fail. Also, if the position changes are done too slowly, the crystal may not settle quickly enough from lack of momentum and the maneuver will also fail. Once the crystal falls out of the canal, the dizziness should resolve if due to posterior canal BPPV.